I lived an active life, with backpacking and camping with my wife and my children. I played a lot of sports and coached baseball for 11 years. I joined the police department in 1975, and the last 17 years of my 37-year career, I spent with the SWAT team. I've always used to preach to my guys in SWAT that it's a adapt and overcome. In the summer of 2013, I began to experience a shooting pain in my right arm. Dr. Torlani recommended surgery, and he explained that there were two ways to do it. One was to fuse the disc, but there was a second method was relatively new, but he had done it successfully, and that was to replace one disc with an artificial disc and then fuse the second disc.
While I was sitting there waiting, the attendant asked me to go to a back room and take the phone with me. And I was thinking, oh, he's finished. He just wants to tell me that they're done and he's moving on. And instead it turned out that he said things weren't going very well.
One of the instruments that he was using malfunctioned and struck my spinal cord. I learned that I was paralyzed from the neck down.
Dr. Tortolani did come out and sat down and talked to me and explained to me what was going on.
He went way beyond apologizing.
I could tell for him it was very hard because he had known Jack for a while.
I had always been a fighter, and I told him, I said, let's get the show on the road. Let's figure out what we're going to do and get it started.
I don't remember exactly when I got the call from the risk manager who's on site at the local hospital. But when he called me, the question was, how do we deal with this? What should we do? When you work in an organization where the directive is to do the right thing, the answers are really easy. Tell them basically anything they need is what we're here to give them. We have to support them.
I was shocked personally that the hospital did say something happened on our watch. We want to be responsible for it and we want to help you in any way we can.
I went in the hospital as a patient, and then I became a victim. And that's not right. As a victim, the early intervention allows the victim slash patient to get on with their life a little quicker.
If we're there in the very beginning, we can make sure they have home health aid, they have somebody in the house to take care of them. They have attendants if they need to, somebody to take care of their needs. In the old traditional way, I'm just looking at picking up the pieces after everything has been broken. In the new way, we're looking at taking those pieces and making sure they're melded together to get the patient the best outcome possible.
MedStar did it all. They did emotional support, they did physical support, and they did monetary support. I think all of those things together are what's going to make it a success.
It was one less thing I had to worry about. It allowed me to concentrate on getting better. That just made life a lot easier for me.